This is the place. And you say, you look up far, far, far away. It's finding dreams, chasing down these meteors and comets called dreams in the sky of life.
What's good, everybody? It's your boy, SJ K-Dot, the first black Super Saiyan in the world around this planet, and I'm back here with another video. Your boy K-Dot got a video for you right now on some real shit. Rest in peace, George Floyd. Rest in peace. I don't care what this man did prior. Supposedly, he used the fake bill to do something, yada, 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 and the person called the cops on him. I don't care what he did prior to what just happened. I'm keep 100. Now, I wouldn't say I'm the smartest person ever. I wouldn't say I'm Einstein genius. I wouldn't say I'm a whiz at things, but I'll say this much. I can see when shit is out of line. For example, this officer had his knee on a man's neck who was cuffed on the ground for at least longer than 2 minutes. You know, like really pushing his knee into his neck, you know, the area where, you know, air comes through. You gotta be able to breathe, you know, you know, if you get choked, you can't really breathe. So homeboy was had his knee on his neck, pushing it down on his neck, cutting off his circulation so he couldn't breathe. Man was pleading for air. They wouldn't listen to him. A dumbass Asian cop is looking and saying blah 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 blah, and then the white cop had his hands in his pockets looking like he the shit when he really not the shit. He just a bitch. That's what he is. And they killed him. I'ma keep wanting it. Each of those officers that was there that protected that officer who has had his knee on the dude's neck from getting jumped by other people, especially civilians, they all deserve to go to rot in the prison because there was accomplices to it. I don't care how long they get in prison, because at the end of the day, once the inmates in there, especially the black inmates, find out what they did, ooh, karma's finna be a beach.
All your money!
Karma's finna hurt. It is gonna hurt bad. This is the thing about it. I'm be real ignorant about this. I'm just gonna be super ignorant. You know, if you don't like what I say about this, it's all good. I don't care. I don't think all cops are bad. I think there's good cops and I think there's bad cops. And I think there's some good cops that are too afraid to speak up against the bad cops because how the cops look at themselves, just like how if people in the military would look at it. You're in a brotherhood of a sense. That's why most people, when they come back from the military, people that have been in the military and they go there, some of them feel attached to it so much that it's like, when they come back to regular civilian life, they're like, what the freak, man? This ain't for me. This ain't for me no more. I need to go back to the military. It's a brotherhood in a sense, and I understand why the cops would protect their own. I understand. It's plain and simple. You know, firefighters protect their own. Everybody protects their own. Hell, black people, we protect our own too. White people protect their own. It's just what you do. That's just what happens when you're part of something. You protect your own. It's just whatever. Now, it's when things are clearly wrong, and it's like you're not calling it out. For example, it was a gang of police officers protecting that the man who killed George Floyd. There was a bunch of them protecting his home, and I was like, okay, yeah. It's clear as day that he murdered somebody. Go ahead and send him to prison. We don't need him to stand no trial. It's clear as day he murdered somebody. Send his ass off. I'm just keeping it 100. But to me, there's good cops and then there's bad cops. That's just how the world is. There's a balance. There's some good people in this world and there's a bad people. That's why there's the concept in most people's religions of a heaven and a hell. There's a good place you go and there's a bad place you go. The world just has the good and the bad. It just isn't one thing good and it just isn't one thing bad. It's good and bad. That's just what it is. Some are good, some are bad. That's just what it is at the end of the day. And that's how I believe on everything. Blacks, police officers, whites, all of us. There's some good and there's some bad. That's just what it is. Another thing I do want to say. you know, there's, I look, I can talk about systematic racism and shit. Look, I'm just telling you, keep in mind at the end of the day, there's just an evil man who did something vile and evil. A man was pleading and begging for air, and you are a peacekeeper. And look, people have that thing about, oh, the cops was manufactured, the cops in America was created to keep oppressing black people. Yeah. But look, I'm keep wanting at the end of the day. The role of a police force in anything is supposed to be, you're supposed to keep the peace. Now, the peace in some cases is different, varying on whatever country you stay in, whatever continent you live at. In the Middle East, it's different. Here, our concept of here, you're the police force. You're supposed to prevent lives from being lost. Now, if you're taking lives, you are contradicting what you're supposed to mainly be doing. You should only do that out of self-defense, or let's say you're in a shootout at some people at a bank and they fire back and you got to fire back. Boom. Then that's when you fight back. Unless certain cases you have to use force and stuff. Unless it's like necessary. But it depends. I'm no police officer, but I'm saying there's circumstances. Now, I will just say that this is a fact of today. More police killings of black people get reported on the news more than black on black crime, gang shootings and shit. There's black people killing black people in the hood almost all the time. But they don't report it no more like that. I don't know why, because it's a gang crime, you know, it's gang affiliation, we don't care. But I notice the media likes to, you know, really pick at the cops. And, you know, look, I'm not saying they can't, but I'm just saying that's just what I've been noticing on the news. You know, more cop killings are being recognized more than even black on black crime, which is also a problem in our own community. Another thing I do want to say, I do want to speak on this topic. At the end of the day, I don't care what George Floyd did. If you try to defend the police officers and say, oh, no proper training, nah. Don't give me that no proper training bullshit. That person's just bad at being human. Have your fucking compassion. That's something your parents should have taught you. If you can't learn compassion, you shouldn't be no police officer at the end of the day. I'm just keeping that 100. You gotta be able to understand people and understand where people are coming from, depending on the situation. He didn't care about nothing. He just said, oh, I'm finna... killed the man. And if he thinks his job is to kill as many people as I can, oh, he's doing good at it because he made it very public and obvious. Fucking dingus. An idiot. And at the end of the day, you guys, at the end of the day, to me, I don't care what it is. I don't care how big it is. I don't care how small it is. Racism is racism to me. That's just what it is. It's just like the other day. Doja Cat supposed to get caught out because she's self-hate, racism, yada, yada, yada. And then Blueface calls her out. But mind you, Blueface made this music video where he reintroduced a racist scene from Next Friday, which was funny, but a racist scene where these Mexicans assumed a bunch of black people, Day-Day, had sugar. You know, the whole thing is sugar, Kool-Aid, black people, you know, that type of shit.
We just came to borrow some sugar.
Some sugar?
Hey, Monster, what you gonna back, fool?
Ah, oh, fuck, alright.
I don't know, homie. Black people got a lot of sugar, homie. It's very suspicious,
homie.
Hey, whatever, smart guy. Fuck, homie. Hold on, dog. You food be making Kool-Aid and shit, fool.
Just came to borrow some sugar, man. I don't want no problem.
And I'm keep 100. I laughed at that shit because it was comedy. I was laughing at it. I'm keep 100. Shit, I might be racist too. When I watch Rush Hour, I'm going to keep it 100 with you guys. When I watch Rush Hour, you guys know I always laugh every time Chris Tucker says, you no speaking no English. Why you no speaking no English? I'll be laughing at that shit. You want to know why? Because it's funny. I think I'm a little bit racist. But I'm keep 100 with you guys. I ain't going to kill nobody just because they look a certain way. That's just what it is, 100. That's just what it is. But still, there's a little bit of racism in me. Shit. Some of y'all racist too. Keep it 100. But this is still not good. This is vile and evil what that man done. And at the end of the day, I was looking at, you know, in Minneapolis, there's a bunch of rioting and looting going on. I never agreed with the concept of rioting and looting. Because it's like this. some points the riots are going to end, you're going to get tired, you want to go, you know, retreat back to your home. And then the next day, you're going to, like, you know, think about what you did yesterday at the riot. And then you got to go, like, huh, now I got to go to the store. Oh, shoot, we just burnt down that store. Let's go to the other one. Oh, damn, we just burnt down that store, too. Oh, dang, where we go now? Then you go back to Target and say, oh, man, they looted this whole joint. There's barely anything in there. They took all the food. Oh, damn, fuck. That type of shit. So it's like, you know. And I'm not saying you can't do that, but I understand why people are this way. I understand why people feel this way. I just don't agree with the concept of rioting and looting. It's like, at the end of the day, you live in this area, and you're destroying the basic stuff that you need, like Target, your grocery store is just burning down buildings and shit. And then it's like, I mean, you're going to have to go shop there the other day because you may want to, you know, get some food and stuff just in case, you know, stock up, and you know, just saying. But, you know, it's whatever. It's all good. I mean, you know, I understand why people are angry. I can understand. You just don't see me out there rioting and looting. But that's why I don't participate in most of these protests anyways. I'll support from afar, but I ain't getting trapped up in that crossfire. Not me. But however you guys feel about this, at the end of the day, this is, has sparked a lot more, this sparked a lot. Now we have these riots going on, now it's becoming more nationwide. I'm here in California and everybody's, you know, they doing their minor protests here and buzzing about it. And now we got this whole little virus going on right at the same time. It's like, bruh, shit. I don't need none of this right now. All this pressure. But when I upload this video, this will be the last time I'm going to speak up on this. Because, you know, I just want to go back to, you know, the pop culture and shit. I had to drop this video because I wanted to speak upon it. Because at the end of the day, bro, there's no ifs, ands, or buts about the thing. All those officers that was there that day, and the ones even who didn't directly kill the man, all need to be in prison. They was associates of murder. They allowed it to happen. They was clearly seeing it happen when they could have prevented it, and the dude died. They all need to go to jail. They was accomplices to it, and they was defending the person that murdered the person. And don't try to tell me, oh, I mean, he didn't know he was cutting off his circulation. He was saying, I can't breathe. And if you have your knee on somebody's neck for more than 2 minutes, you should already know that you're cutting off the circulation for them to breathe. So if you defend this and try to tell me that he didn't know that he was cutting off his circulation, you're gonna sound retarded. You're gonna sound really stupid if you try to tell me that. If I have my hand around somebody's neck for at least longer than a minute, I'm cutting off the circulation so they can't breathe. If I'm strangling someone, they can't breathe. They're gonna have trouble breathing, and they're probably gonna potentially die. So don't try to get here and tell me that that was not what we saw. I saw the footage. I saw what I saw. My eyes don't lie to me. That wasn't Photoshop. That wasn't fake. That was very much real. If you can't accept that was real and you're trying to defend these four, don't even defend them. They don't deserve no defense. Don't even try to make a case for them. Because at the end of the day, you can only be on one side here. You're either against these four officers, the officers there, or you're kind of not against them, but you're in the middle, or you fully support what they did. It's either you fully support what they did, or you don't. I wouldn't even try to pick a middle ground on this situation, because what those four clearly did was wrong. This is like me trying to say, dang, dude's a serial killer, but like, he's not all that bad. I mean, he killed like 10 babies and raped like 5 women, but he's not that bad. I mean, I can kind of see where he's coming from, why he would do that. It's that type of shit. No. So, overall, everybody, just be safe out here. Watch yourselves, protect yourselves. Do what you gotta do. I don't agree with the rioting and looting. I really don't agree with that concept during protests. Because at the end of the day, the people that live in that area, I mean, it's less beneficial to people that don't live there. But if you live there in the city that you're burning down, and at the end of the day, you know, you're gonna have to cease your rioting. You're gonna get tired and you're gonna go home. And then the next day, you go like, man, we need some supplies and shit. Gotta go to the store. Oh, shit, we burnt it down. All the stuff is gone. So, yeah. That's all I'm saying about this situation. But, rest in peace, George Floyd. That was not right what they did. That clearly was not right at all. And you can see it as it wasn't right. And if you try to tell me that you see different, then that's what it is. To me, racism is racism. I don't care what it is. It can be little, it can be big. Racism is racism. That's just how it is. I don't care how big it is, how little it is. If you're racist, you're racist. Damn, shit. I laughed at that. Damn, yeah, just like I was watching Rush Hour. I laugh at all those racist-ass jokes Jackie Chan makes about Chinese people. No, Chris Tucker. Fuck. I think I'm a little bit racist. Watch yourselves. Protect yourselves. Go serve that peace, love, positivity all the time. Don't do drugs. Deuces.
Equity and equality. The end result, we all, the ones that don't want to live in misery, that is, desire. Now, naturally, we all, black and white, are schadenfreude, or are malicious. Here are a few examples. Emmett Till, August 28th, 1955, Mississippi, pulled out of his house in the middle of the night in front of his mother, who had to watch her son be taken from her on the sidelines for little to no reason at all worth murdering a 14-year-old boy. Castrated, mutilated, but also documented for the youth to see. Corey Ali Muhammad, black on white. Philando Castile, white on black. Now these things never come to or remotely ever remain in the public eye, and the youth is never inspired to take a stand to make a difference. So I will speak for them. The youth, that is, the ones full of innocence, the ones inspired by the things around them to matter. I can go on forever about the fact that murder is murder, whether you're black or white. You should always feel free to voice your opinion. But to act out on these irrational thoughts in every shape or form is disgusting. You cannot, as black or white, call yourself the supreme race when moved out of your comfort by the opposition's color, their skin color. That is no form of being or demonstrating being a supreme being. If you are a supremacist, be unmoved by the opposition. Remain unscathed in the comfort of your own home, in your own realm. Demonstrate care for the youth's future, white or black, black or white. Are you willing to risk your child's future due to your own bigotry? The choice is yours, but your child will not stand for the hate. This generation will be loved, nurtured, heard, and understood.
You could have gone for the